Hey everybody, it's KartFab here, and today we're going to learn about a go-kart engine mount, go-kart engine, the clutch, as well as the drive wheel assembly, which includes the wheel, sprocket, and brake. And we're going to learn about how to put all of this stuff together, so let's go and check it out. So the go-kart parts that came in the go-kart kit included a chain, and the chain was a little bit too long, so we're going to remove the master link from the chain and cut it. The master link includes the spring, plate, and plate with pins. Next, we're going to mount the engine to the motor mount, or the engine mounting plate. Basically, you take the block and you set it on top of the plate, and you put the four engine mounting bolts in between the block and the motor mount, and slide the engine back and secure all four bolts. When mounting the go-kart clutch to the go-kart engine, you want to make sure it lines up just right with the drive wheel assembly sprocket. The reason why you do that is so the chain will spin freely and it won't cause excessive wear, and so it won't fling the chain off. So slide the clutch on, then slide the drive wheel assembly on, and make sure you hand tighten the bolt on the dead axle. The reason why you do this is you don't want the bearings to bind. So if you remember earlier, we were talking about the chain was too long. So after you have the engine in place, put the chain around the sprocket and mark the plate that you want to have removed. Now there's two ways to remove these, two or three main ways. I'm just going to do it the easy way. You grind down a little bit of the plate and you break it off. You can also use a chain break tool, or you can use a nail and a hammer and put the chain in a vise and tap out the pin itself. Now that you have your master link taken out and your chain cut to size, you want to put everything back together with the drive wheel. So you put the chain around the sprocket until everything lines up great. You take the plate with pins and the other plate, and then the spring clip, and you put the spring clip in the grooves. And then you take a flathead screwdriver or pliers and you pop the link right back on. So make sure that the open end is towards the back and the closed end is towards the front, so it won't pop off when you're driving. After you have the go-kart chain assembled, you want to have a little bit of slack left in it before you weld the motor mount to the frame. After you have it all aligned, take some C-clamps and clamp the motor mount to the go-kart frame, and then do a final check with a straight edge between the drive wheel assembly and the centrifugal clutch drive sprocket. Sometimes it helps to spin the drive wheel assembly just to make sure, because sometimes they're a little bit out of round and you want to make sure that it's centered even when it wobbles back and forth just a tiny bit. So after everything is perfectly straight, go ahead and tack weld the four separate corners of the go-kart engine mounting plate. After you have everything tacked, go ahead and weld. This is an example of a very poor weld. Notice how it's built up on the left. If you screwed up a weld, you can either grind it down or weld over top of it if it's a decent weld to begin with. This is a stick welder that I'm using. Notice that I'm pausing at the bottom of the weld and the top of the weld, back and forth moving forward. This is a generally accepted way of welding with a stick welder. And you might be wondering, why am I welding with a stick welder? Just showing you that there's no matter what welding you use, you can do it with MIG, TIG, or stick. So after everything is welded together, you want to do a final assembly just to make sure everything is perfect. You go ahead and take the bolts for the engine block and put them through the engine block and make sure it goes through the engine mounting plate and slide it forward. Then you want to secure the clutch to the engine shaft with a fine thread 5/16 inch bolt. And then you're done. Thanks for watching, guys. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up, comment, rate, and subscribe. Now, if you've been watching the series on how to build a go-kart, you're going to know that the previous video was how to attach the floor pan to the go-kart frame, and the next video is how to attach the seat to the frame that came in the go-kart kit that you can get at kartfab.com. Have a good one.